Welcome to the Morning Update. I'm Erin Ramsey. New South Wales health officials are still investigating the source of a new COVID-19 case in Sydney. A man in his 50s tested positive after visiting 13 venues across Sydney. They've all been listed on New South Wales Health's website. New South Wales Chief Health Officer Kerry Chant says contact tracing is continuing.
We're keeping an open mind at this time, and obviously we are looking at whether there's any match to any known returning travellers.
Visitors from other states who may have been to any of those exposure sites are also urged to isolate and get tested. COVID-19 has also been detected at the G7 meeting in London. The entire Indian delegation is self-isolating after two positive cases were identified. British Prime Minister Boris Johnson is defending the decision to allow delegations into the UK without being tested.
I think it's very important to continue as much business as you can as a government. We have a very important relationship with India, with our G7 partners.
The federal government is again defending the temporary ban on Australian citizens returning home from India. It follows federal court action by a man who's among the 9,000 Australians locked out of the country until at least May 15. Immigration Minister Alex Hawke says the ban does not breach human rights regulations.
We have acted in the context of a global pandemic to temporarily pause flights from a country that is rated high risk by our health officials.
And the Australian Olympic Committee says athletes shouldn't fear being stranded in Japan after the Tokyo Games. President John Coates has issued a statement following Australia's cricketers in India being locked out until at least May 15. He says the Australian Olympic team will be fully vaccinated and the risk of infection in Tokyo is very small. Staying on sport news, former Parramatta Eels player Jarryd Jayne will be sentenced today after being found guilty of two charges of rape in New South Wales. Jayne can expect 14 years jail with 7 years non-parole. South Sydney plays Melbourne, kicking off round 9 of the NRL at Stadium Australia tonight. Melbourne won 26-18 when the teams met in round 1. In the A-League, Brisbane Roar has come from 1-0 down to beat Western United 2-1. And in tennis, Ash Barty is into the semi-finals of the Madrid Open after beating Petra Kvitova. In entertainment news, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge have created their very own YouTube channel. Kate and Prince William made the announcement with a montage video of their royal engagements. Royal fans are hoping to see more family videos, though, like the one posted for the couple's 10th wedding anniversary. Adele has shared a series of photos to Instagram to mark her 33rd birthday. The megastar looks relaxed and makeup-free in the snaps, which she captioned 30-free. Coldplay is set to debut a new track during a hookup with the International Space Station. Chris Martin has confirmed they'll premiere Higher Power as part of an extraterrestrial transmission, with fans able to tune in through YouTube. And Facebook's independent oversight board has upheld a decision to keep Donald Trump off the social media platform. No surprises, the former president isn't happy with the decision, calling it a total disgrace. That's your latest from the Nova Podcasts team. We'll see you this afternoon for another episode of The Update. We'll be right back.